For those of you who are taking communicative abilities in English 1, wanted to provide a few minutes here of feedback related to your problem statement. I've had a chance to take a look at those of you who have submitted your assignment to the virtual classroom. Today is September 11th, 2022. And it is about 8:30 in the morning. So at this point, some of you have uploaded your assignments. Do make sure that you have copied and pasted the text. If you're working in your Word document in Microsoft Teams, you copied and pasted that into the assignment when submitting your assignment to the virtual classroom. So a couple of things here that I want to list that I would like for you to take a look at when you are looking at your problem statement. Now, the problem statement, remember that it should include three sections: the topic, the indirect question, singular, one indirect question that begins with a one question word. How or why are going to be our most common types of question words. This is going to be our preferred way of beginning our indirect question. So, because I want to know how something, I want to know why. And then we should also have the significance beginning with the prompt in order to. All right, so remember that the prompt, the entire prompt that includes one sentence, should begin as follows. I wish to learn more about, so everybody will begin with those words, and then you list out your topic. Because I want to know how, or because I want to know why. Again, a how question and or a why question are going to be our most preferred ways of developing our indirect question. So our indirect question begins with because I want to know, etc. How or why. Try to avoid question words like what or which. Also, I did see some cases where the topic included or started with a question word. The topic should not begin with a question word. Only the indirect question, okay, should begin with a question word. And then we have in order to. Now, remember that this is one sentence, so I know that we talked about, you know, I on the board divided it up and listed it three different sections, but it's essentially one sentence, okay? So there are going to be no periods until at the very end after you have stated, again, the topic, the indirect question, and the significance. Now, one of the hardest things to do at this point when we're developing a problem statement is to try to narrow down our indirect question. Now, we talked about in class different ways or different approaches that you could follow to try to narrow down your indirect question. Again, your indirect question within your problem statement begins with, because I want to know how, or because I want to know why. So think of trying to combine several keywords that relate to the language learning or the language classroom experience. Some of the example words that we talked about in class include listening and speaking, reading and writing, grammar, vocabulary, pronunciation, technologies or materials, teaching techniques or learning strategies. You could also think of cognitive strategies, social strategies. You could also consider students working in pairs or in groups, small groups. Okay, that's relates to social learning. So, you know, maybe you have some articles that discuss heterogeneous and homogeneous types of groups and the benefits of those that you could include in your essay. But again, you're trying to combine some of these words in your indirect question in attempt to make your indirect question more specific. Remember that the indirect question really is the central, the one question that your essay later will address. All right, now the other thing I want you to think about, and we haven't talked a lot about this so far, we'll talk about it on Monday, but you'll want to think about the indirect question, and you need to recognize whether your indirect question relates to a problem or a possible solution. Now, I know that we're labeling this one sentence as the problem statement, but the problem statement really doesn't come into effect usually until the significance, when you say in order to. When you're thinking about your target audience and you're thinking, well, to whom would benefit, to whom am I writing this essay? Who would benefit the most having read my essay? Maybe it's new teachers working in public schools. Maybe it's to parents of children. Maybe it's to administrators. Whomever it is, you're trying to think about who would benefit the most. Who are you writing your essay to? And when you take that into consideration, you need to also think about, well, what problem are you addressing? So again, the problem really should be considered in the significance so that you have really a purpose for writing your essay. And typically, the purpose of writing an essay or writing or even doing research is to have some kind of problem, to have a problem that you're addressing. If there really is no problem, then there's really no sense to doing the research or even writing the essay, if you want to think of it like that. All right, so here we have the indirect question, and look at your indirect question as it is now and ask yourself, am I addressing a problem or a possible solution? At this point, I'll give you the option of writing your essay either as developing the problem or explaining a problem or providing a possible answer. But it's important that you recognize what you're doing. Which of those are you really addressing? And it all comes back to the indirect question. Remember the indirect question. This is the central question of your essay. So if the question relates to a problem, then your whole essay is going to be about the problem. If the indirect question addresses a possible solution, then your entire essay primarily will be focused on a possible solution, thinking specifically of the body paragraphs. So this is something we're going to be talking about in class, trying to identify our indirect question as either addressing a problem or addressing a possible solution. Now, there are some cases where I left some feedback suggesting that it might be best to focus more on a possible solution. So there are some situations, some of you who have chosen to focus on a problem, that because of the nature of the problem that you chose, it might be best to focus on a solution because perhaps the problem is not really debatable. Remember that a good topic and a good indirect question needs to be debatable. It needs to be a topic that can be debated on both sides. Not because we have to necessarily do that for the purposes of this essay. You're only going to need to provide evidence to support one side of the argument, but theoretically there should be a topic there that you have that you're going to be writing about that there could be both sides. There could be an argument that could be developed on both sides. If you're choosing a problem really that no one would really disagree with, that's an example of a topic or problem that's not really debatable. Okay, I think I mentioned this before. For the indirect question, typically we're going to choose either a how question or a why question. We could choose a where or when question, but we probably do not want to choose a what or a which question word. Also, avoid contractions. Avoid the word important or importantly or importance. Also, we'll later talk about some additional words to avoid, like essential and vital. It is essential. It is vital. We'll talk more about that later. But I did see an example of important that I would probably avoid, the word important. And throughout our academic text, we'll want to avoid contractions. So generally speaking, this is what I saw so far. This is the kind of feedback that I left in the virtual classroom to those who have already uploaded the assignment. I think today will be the last day to submit, so if you haven't already, go ahead and try to upload your assignments. And again, on Monday, we'll go over the same feedback that I'm sharing with you here today, and we'll talk specifically about identifying our indirect question as it as being either related to the problem or a possible solution. And we'll talk about a few other things regarding the research matrix, making sure you're able to come up with enough articles from peer-reviewed journals that address your topic, and also have some time here to help anyone who feels that you are still needing to find more articles to support your topic. We'll focus mainly on that on Monday. Continue working as much as possible in the shared Word document in Microsoft Teams. We'll continue working in the same document throughout this whole unit as we develop our first draft. Our first draft is going to be due September 23rd. Then we'll have one complete week to work on the final draft to have that completed by September 30th. Okay, so we'll stop there for today, and we'll see everybody in class on Monday.